So you just got the Blackmagic Design DaVinci Resolve Speed Editor. Maybe it's on pre-order or you're thinking about it, but you need to realize you need to rethink how you mark and use your favorite shots. So today, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you three different ways how you can break down your project and use just your selects using the Speed Editor. Let's dive in. So here we are in the cut page of DaVinci Resolve 17, and I'm gonna pull up Source. By hitting Source, it's actually pulling up Source Tape, which is this icon right here, and it's pulling up every single clip that's in my project all at once. So I can use the search dial and scroll through and try to find that specific shot. Now, you can even narrow this down further. It's almost like you have multiple source tapes if you look at your bins. So if you take a look in the upper left here, we can say, I want to only see Broncos shots. So by doing that, we can see over here in my source tape, I am only looking, I've sort of restricted my search to just those. And if I wanted to look at just sign store shots, that has restricted it to that as well. So basically what this is doing is it's giving you multiple source tapes per project based off of your bin structure, and you don't have to make extra timelines or string outs for it. Welcome, I'm Chadwick, and I want to let you know in the description box down below, I have timestamps, chapter markers, they're there for you, use them. It's so you don't have to waste time looking at stuff that you already know about, and you can get right back to the work you're doing. And also if you're a new editor, I want to let you know the reason this video exists to begin with, you know, about making selects, so that we're only looking at the bad parts of a shot one single time. It's when you're making the selects. It also is an opportunity to organize your project, and who doesn't like an organized project? All right, let's jump in. I'm gonna show you how to use the source tape using subclips with the speed editor. So the way we're gonna use selects using the source tape is to make subclips. And to use subclips here in the project, it's gonna be easiest if we create a smart bin. So if you've never done that before, we're gonna be in the media page. We're gonna go down to smart bins. Okay, and we're gonna right click in this area and say smart add smart bin. And doing this, it's basically saying anything that has these values is gonna be added to the smart bin. And we're gonna do that for subclips. So we're gonna call this selects subclips, okay? And to change it, we're gonna change, media pool properties is good. We're gonna change the file name here is gonna be subclip. And we're gonna say is true. And you're gonna click this show in all projects. And what this is doing is anytime you have a project open with that's within this database, it's already gonna have this bin for you. So you only have to do this once. We'll hit create. And now we have a bin here that's automatically gonna put our subclips in there after we create them. Now to create them, we're gonna jump over into our edit page, which is shift 4. And in shift 4, we can go and find our bin that we want to take a look at. Why don't we look at this sign footage and find something that's cool in here. So why don't we look at this one? We should be able to use the search dial on the speed editor to find a section of the clip that we like that we'll call our select. Okay. So I like this little tilt up right here. Kind of gives a little depth to the shot. We're going to mark an in with the search dial and an out with the search dial. And then we're going to make a subclip out of it. Couple different ways to make a subclip. This is the first way. You can click and drag from the source monitor over into here. And by doing that, it moved a subclip in there that has those new limits. And you can check that by going down to the smart bins. And we see we have indeed a smart clip. And the smart clip extents are basically what we had marked as our in and out. Okay, so that is our new select. That's what we're gonna work with over in source tape. The other ways to make a subclip is basically you could use a keyboard shortcut. So like if we go back over here into our sign bucket of footage, let's find another shot we want to make a select of. Double click this one to load it up. And let's find a shot. This is cool with the close up. So let's make a select out of some of this drilling right here. So we'll mark an in right here, let it play as it's going down doing the drilling. And moves on to the next thing, and we'll mark it out so it's a little bit loose. And then you can use the keyboard shortcut option B on your keyboard, and that has just made a subclip of that, which goes into there. And then if you also want to know where this exists up in the menu system, which is always a helpful thing to know, we'll do one more subclip that way. I don't know, let's take a look at this sign right here and see. Okay, so there's sort of a pan across of this neon sign. Mark an endpoint, scroll the out point, and if you go, it's under mark up top here. So if you go to mark and then create subclip is right here, which it also reminds you that's option B. So now we have three subclips that we've created. So we have three selects. And the next little step you still need to do before you can use this in source tape is create an actual bin of subclips that's not a smart bin. Because if you're in the cut page, you don't have access to smart bins. At least right now in version 17, it doesn't exist. So I'll stay here in the edit page, I'll right click, I'll say new bin, and I'll call this my sign selects. Okay, so then we go down here to our subclips that we've made. We're gonna click and drag those on over into our sign selects bin. That's an actual bin. Now to edit with them, we're finally there. It took a little bit of setup, and I think this will go much faster once you're used to it. We're gonna hit Shift 3 to get to the cut page. This is a clip that we don't need on the timeline, so I'm gonna ripple delete that. We're gonna load up our source tape, and now you can see we are in our bin for sign selects. And if I hit scroll, it's gonna let us get to each of those clips really quickly. And then it's just a matter of editing into the timeline like you normally would. So maybe I wanna start with this clip right here. I'd hit append, that gets it to our timeline. And then we wanna go to this shot here. I'd say append with that one, and then this one, append. And the rest of it's just editing like normal. So that is how you would use selects using subclips in the source tape. One thing real quick to understand with subclips is it creates a hard extent on a clip once it's edited on the timeline, meaning I don't have those handles available to me anymore. You can get those back though. If you just select the clip and right click it, and then you can say edit subclip from that contextual menu, then click use full clip extents and say update. Now I should be able to take that clip and trim the out point of it, which you can see I can do now. I hope you found that source tape tip really helpful. I want to let you know, if you're new to this channel, it's called Creative Video Tips and I'm Chadwick. The channel is all about creating videos that make a difference and stand out. If that's something you're into, I would love for you to subscribe. That way you don't miss out on the tip next week. Next up, I'm going to be showing you how to use markers in the edit page to pull your selects. So the second way of making selects, we're actually going to use a full timeline. So this is a timeline that just has all these shots from the Broncos practice facility all in one timeline. And we're going to load that into our source. And the way we're gonna do that is just click and drag over here. And then we're gonna open a new blank timeline called best edit ever, because of course it is the best edit ever. And we're gonna edit straight into the timeline. If I tap source, this gives us access to that full timeline that we had seen with all of those Broncos clips. And we just need to make sure two things are turned on for this to work correctly. We're gonna go to edit menu. We're gonna turn on switch to timeline after edit. And we're also gonna turn on decompose compound clips on edit. Okay, by doing this, it basically pulls from the source clip, not from the compound clip, which is what you wanna do. So those are enabled. We can go back to our source. We can go along here and mark anything that we like. So the way we mark on here with the speed editor is, let's find the part we like. Okay, there's a little move up. We'll do a double tap there on the speed editor. That put a mark down. And if we scroll, we can kind of go a little quicker. Why don't we grab a shot right there, double tap that. And so we're gonna put these two on the timeline really quickly. The way we're gonna do that is go back, we can now identify where our favorite spots are up here, okay? We can go and say, let's mark an in point there, an out point there, and then we can do an append, and then we'll go back up to source, go to the next shot that we like, in point, you know, before it zooms out, out point, and append. Okay, so now we've got those two shots that were basically worked from making selects. What I would do is go up here and make all your marks where you want them first, then you can use those in any timeline really quickly. A couple navigation things you can do up here if you don't have the speed editor or you don't want to use it. If you use the up and down arrows, this is actually snapping me to every single clip that is on that timeline that is basically inside that compound clip. And if you add the shift to your up and down arrows, it jumps you to the markers. So this is actually, if you put marks on what your select areas of the timeline are, this is the way to get there really fast. If you do up and down and you just wanna drop a whole clip here in the edit page, like this is the beginning of a shot, I can tap X, which marks an in and out that's specific to just that clip. I can just quickly say, I wanna append that to the end of my timeline. And it's ready to go. And that's the full clip. That's not an in and out that I had to specifically mark. So using X up here to mark the in and end of each specific shot is a great little tool. So that's my tip on how you can use markers to edit from one timeline to another timeline using the search style and the keyboard sort of combined. So the last method for selects I want to show you is called pancake editing, or stacked timelines is a DaVinci Resolve term. And it's been around for a while. You just need the mouse, no speed editor. Let's check it out. We're gonna move this to the side and we're just gonna use the mouse. And I'm gonna show you a technique called stacked timelines to deploy your selects. If you click in this window right over here with the mouse, okay, we are gonna check this box right here, which allows for stacked timelines. You could also do tabbed timelines if you click that plus button, but we're gonna go over here and do stacked. So by clicking this, we can have two timelines open at the same time. Actually, you can have a lot more than two. We can choose the timeline we want at the bottom, which of course is best edit ever. And we're gonna go to the end of the timeline and we can just click and drag from one to the other. So let's say I wanna grab these shots. These are my favorite shots. I'm gonna click and hold and drag those down here to the timeline below. And now they actually exist. All our favorite shots from that first timeline are in this timeline. And it's really just as simple as that. So stack timelines. You can add more if you click here if you want, but that gives you the general idea. Now you're basically a professional assistant editor. You know everything there is to know about making selects, pulling selects with keyboard, speed editor, with mouse. If you got something out of this video, I'd love for you to hit the like button right now. And if you're interested in learning more about the speed editor or DaVinci Resolve, I have a playlist that should be coming up right around now. And it'll teach you a lot more if you want to learn about multicam, everything you do with the search style, maybe how to trim. All that stuff is up in there. I think it's great stuff. You're going to learn a lot. And I'll see you over in those videos. Thanks.